자, 그러면 오늘 MTTK를 한번 시작을 해 볼게요, 여러분. 오늘 노래는요, 제목이 이겁니다. Today's song is 도로남이에요. 도로남. 도로 is turning back as again. Again as turning back. That's 도로예요. 도로. Oh, do you know the meaning of 도로 actually? There is a noun, 도로, which is referring to the road. Yeah, the road. That's 도로예요. But as an adverb, this is again, but again with the meaning of turning back. All right, return to something. That's again 도로입니다. 도로. And 남 as a noun, others or strangers is 남이요. We can put 들 there for the plural nouns, 남들. But 남 is others, strangers, 도로남. So 도로남 means strangers again, turning back to the strangers, turning back to the others, or returning to the others. Okay, it has the meaning of breaking up, right? 도로남이에요. 도로남. 도로남. 그러면 우리 한번 노래 듣고 가사 보고 공부를 해봅시다. Let's listen to the song first and then study some lyrics together. 해볼게요, 여러분. 노래 듣고 올게요. Enjoy!
님이 되어 만난 사람도
잘 듣고 왔나요, 여러분? Did you enjoy the song? 한번 공부를 해볼게요, 여러분. 자, 이 여섯 가지 단어가 나왔어요. There were these six words. All of these six words are just one letter, right? One letter words. But they look very, very similar, right? 님, 남, 돈, 돌, 정, 멍. Right? Let's talk about these three words with the pairs. Okay. 님, 남, 돈, 돌, 정, 멍. Okay. Those all of them are pretty important words. So, and very useful words. So, let's talk about it together. First one, similar words. Number one, 님 and 남. 님 and 남. These two have just one different vowel, e vowel and a vowel, right? 님, 남. 님 is very familiar, right? I always say this to you guys. 리나스 님, 이보나 님, 탈리아 님, 비비 님, 비 님, right? 님, name plus 님 is the respect way to call someone, right? 님. But independently, just 님. So we can call someone 님아, 님. It can be my love. Okay? Not always, guys. But when you call your lovers 님, 내 님, like this, it is my love. It is pretty, not pretty. It is very poetic way to call your lovers just 님. Okay? So normally people don't really call their lovers 님 in daily lives, but they can be like write. They can be like save someone's, not someone's, their lovers on their in their phone, 님, something like that. Okay, so in poem or in the lyrics, 님 can be my love. Got it? Lovers. But 남 is others or strangers. Others and strangers, pretty simple one. So 님, 남. So in the lyrics, 님이라는 글자인 the 님 letter. 점 하나만 붙이면 when we make a dot, so e vowel can be changed into a vowel, right? With a dot. So 님, my love, can be changed into strangers with a dot, with only just the dot, right? Do you agree? Do you feel for it? I feel for it. It doesn't have to be just people like the couples, like. Just people, relationship in with other people, we had affections, but with something, with a tiny point, we can be strangers again, right? 님이라는 글자에 저만 아마 붙이면 with a dot 남이 되어버립니다. Others, right? So, 님 is pretty simple. So I prepared two sentences about 남 because it's a new word for our lessons. 남의 물건에 손대지 마세요. 남의 물건, 남, others, 의, of, 물건, stuff, thing. So, other stuff is 남의 물건. 손, hand, 대다, 대다, touch, 지 마세요. Don't. Do not touch other stuff. 남의 물건에 손대지 마세요. You can see this sentence at school a lot. Especially at elementary school. Yeah. Elementary school teachers always say this to their students. 남의 물건에 손대지 마세요. Do not touch other stuff. Like this. Okay? Second one. 남들이 보면 뭐라고 해? 남들이 보면 뭐라고 해? 남들. Like this. With 들. It can be also the plural. Others. Others. 남들이 보면 보다. See. Look at. 보면 if. When. When others look at you, see you, or see something, 뭐라고 해, 뭐라고, what, 해, do. Do what is judge. 뭐라고 하다 is to judge people. 남들이 보면 뭐라고 해요. 남들이 보면 뭐라고 해. So stop that. So don't do that. Others would judge you when they see it, when they see you. 남들이 보면 뭐라고 해. 남들이 보면 뭐라고 해요? Like this. Okay? We can use 남 in these kind of sentences. Mm-hmm. 좋아요. Next one. Next similar word is 돈 versus 돌. They have different 받침, right? Do you know what 받침 is, everyone? Hopefully. My soul means student should know 받침, right? The last syllable, the last consonant in the syllable is 받침이라고 해요. 받침. So 도, 도, they have same consonant and the vowel, but the last consonant, 받침, is different. The first one is 니은 받침, 돈은상, 돈. Second one has 리을 받침. 을 받침. So, 돈 and 돌이에요. 돈 refers to money입니다. Money. 돌 refers to stone이에요. Very simple words. 돈, money, 돌, stone이에요. 돈, 돌. There is a very good phrase with these two words. Even in the song. 돈이라는 글자에 받침 하나 바뀌면 돌이 돼요. When we change the 받침 in 돈 letter, it changes into 돌, right? Money changes into stone. It is this one. 돈 보기를 돌같이 하다. Look at the money like a stone, which means don't be blinded by money. Money is not important always. Money is not always important. So, don't follow only the money. To do that, in order to do that, look at the money like a stone. 돈 보기를 돌 같이 하다. Even in the song, 돈 and 돌, they have just different 받침. Okay? So, 돈 and 돌. 돈 큰 문제예요. 맞아요, 탈리아님. In this capitalism, of course. But I agree with this. Let's talk about it after the class with all these similar words together, guys. Anyways, that's why in the song, in the lyrics, they were 돈 and 돌. Okay? 돈, money, 돌, stones입니다. Last one is 정 and 멍. Very, very, very important. 정, 정. and mong. They have different first consonants, right? First one, chong has ji, it, j, j, j sound, chong. Second one has mi, consonant, m, m sound, mong, yeah, mong. Oh, also, guys, the 받침 in these two syllables, they have 이응 받침, right? Which sound, right? But be careful. There are pretty many English speakers who pronounce 응 받침 like 응 because of the romanization and because of the English pronunciation. It has 응 sound, right? Sometimes, especially with other words, you can pronounce 응 like, like singer, like this. But in Korean, 이응 받침 doesn't have 응 sound. It has just 응 sound, okay? So not 정 or 멍. This is 정, 멍, yeah. So like 영어, English in Korean is 영어. But I heard lots of Korean learners pronounce it like 영어, 영어, because of 영 sound. Okay, but be careful of that. 영어, 영어 is the right one. Got it? All right, back to today's lesson. 정 and 멍, yeah. 정 is very important concept in Korea. Very, very important concept. I will just read the definition here. The warm feeling of attachment felt between people who share a close relationship. So 정 is a feeling, sharing feeling between people who get along for a long time. Pretty long time. But it's not always same. There are, of course, there are lots of different standards for different people. So people between them can feel 정 like in 2 days or 3 days. If they travel abroad, they could have 정, right? But normally 정 happens in a long time. Okay, 정, yeah, 정. 정 is pretty, I think. So, in the dictionary, and I also translate it as affection, affection, but not romantically. It's just affection between people. It's 정이에요, 정. I have 정 with my soulmates, like this. 라고 합니다. 정이고요. 멍은 bruise예요, bruise. On our body, we could have bruise, right, on our body. That's 멍, yeah, 멍 as a noun. 정 is also a noun too. So let's practice with some sentences. Interestingly, both 정 and 멍 use same verb. 들다, yeah, 들다. 들다 can be get or happen. So 정 들었어요. I became attached to someone, somewhere, something. We can use this expression for all those who, where, what. 저 이 집에 정 들었어요. 이 집 정 들었어요. I became attached to this house. 저 선생님 정 들었어요. I became attached to my teacher. Okay? What else? 저 제 휴대폰 정 들었어요. I became attached to my cell phone. You can use like this. All of who, where, what. Okay? That's 정 들었어요. 멍 들었어요. I got bruised on my body part. 팔에 멍 들었어요. In this case, you have to use the particle 에. 팔에 멍 들었어요. I got bruised on my arm. 얼굴에 멍 들었어요. Oh, that's pretty creepy, but I got bruised on my face. 얼굴에 멍 들었어요. 다리에 멍 들었어요. I got bruised on my legs. 다리에 멍 들었어요. So, 정 들었어요. 멍 들었어요. Also, we can use the verb 주다, which means to give with this. 정 주다. I made an effort to have attachment between us. In this case, I give 정 to you. I tried. I give 정. I give you love, I give you affection. That's 정 주다. 정 줬어요. But people, at first, normally give 정, right? To be close, to be closer and closer. Between couples or between friends, between family, giving 정 is very important. But in the end, not always, when it's time to break up, 멍 줘요. 멍을 주다. We make people get bruised, right? 정 주다, 멍 주다. Very poetic, but pretty sad, right? But that's the life, right? So, 정 들었어요. 정 줘요. 멍 들었어요. 멍 줘요. 이번 주도 화이팅 하세요. Have a wonderful week. 안녕.